This is Tom. Tom is currently involved in a number of projects and clinical studies. One of the project teams consists of himself and two colleagues, Claudia and Mark. Today, we will accompany Tom and his team throughout a typical day at work. You will see how they use O365 to organize and coordinate their working tasks. 7:15 a.m., Tom is taking the bus to work. With his smartphone, he scans through the new emails in his Outlook inbox. There are already quite a few unread messages. 7:30 a.m., after reading through his emails, Tom realizes that he now has several new tasks to complete. In order for him to gain a better overview of his personal tasks for the day, he enters them into the To-Do app. This saves him from having to write yet another note on paper. 8 a.m., Tom arrives at work, takes his laptop out and boots it up. Tom's colleague Claudia contacts him via the Teams chat. She wants to know when the internal kickoff for their newest project will take place, and she could not find the date in the Outlook calendar. Tom quickly replies via the Teams chat that the kickoff will take place today, and that he will send the meeting invitation as soon as possible. Tom opens his Outlook calendar and checks Claudia's and Mark's availability with the scheduling assistant. Tom labels the appointment in Outlook as a team kickoff meeting, beginning today at 3 p.m., then sends the meeting invitations to Claudia and Mark. There are still some things to prepare before the internal kickoff. Tom has to update the presentation draft and add some budget planning figures as additional information. For the new project, Tom creates a new team in the Teams app and names it Research Study Number 365. He then invites Claudia and Mark to join the new team. Claudia receives a message in the Teams activity feed that reads, "Tom has added you to Research Study Number 365. Claudia clicks on the message, and the corresponding team page pops up on her screen. Instead of sending her initial ideas and comments to Tom only, Claudia posts them in the Conversations tab of the new team page. By turning an individual conversation into a group conversation, Claudia ensures that the whole team stays up to date on the project's progress and the communication becomes more transparent for all involved. 8:30 a.m. After drinking a cup of coffee, Tom starts with the project planning. He creates a new tab dedicated specifically to project planning in Teams. Since he is already working on a related file in SharePoint, Tom links this file directly in the new project planning tab. In PowerPoint, Tom creates a presentation for the internal kickoff and stores it in the Files tab on the corresponding team page. This way, all team members can work on the document simultaneously. Tom also adds the file as a new tab so that everyone can more quickly and easily access it. 10 a.m. Now it's time for Tom to do some budget planning in Excel. Tom has the Excel file saved privately in OneDrive, but now he uploads it to the common team page. Since some important figures are still missing, Tom calls Claudia via Teams to shortly discuss where to find the information. He then assigns Claudia the task via Planner to add these values to the Excel file. In order to quickly clarify a few open questions, Tom writes to Mark in the Conversations tab of the Teams chat. Tom tags Mark using the at symbol so that Mark will receive an extra notification about the new message. 3 p.m. The internal kickoff meeting is starting. Since Tom's project team is working from different locations and time zones, the meeting takes place as a web conference via Teams. All participants previously received a link to the web conference in their appointment invitation. With just a few clicks, the meeting can begin. Tom shares his laptop screen with Claudia and Mark, which contains a PowerPoint presentation. Tom also records the meeting for documentation purposes. Claudia is online with her tablet, while Mark participates in the web conference using his smartphone as he is based in the U.S. 4:10 p.m. The kickoff web conference went well. Claudia typed her notes and added screenshots from the session in OneNote, and she now wishes to share these meeting minutes with the rest of the team. To do this, she creates a new tab on the Teams page and links the corresponding OneNote section in the tab. Now the entire team can access the minutes and add their additional notes. Thanks to the Stream app, Tom's video recording is automatically processed and made available to all team members. 4:30 p.m. Several new topics and related work tasks were discussed during the web session. Tom enters these new tasks into Planner and assigns some of them to Claudia, Mark, and himself. Tom revises the checklists of his tasks to ensure that everyone is up to date and aware of the individual sub-steps. To ensure that important milestones are reached, Tom adds progress statuses and due dates for the tasks accordingly. 4:45 p.m. Tom goes on Yammer, a social network for companies. Here, he informs himself about current events within the organization, shared by other company employees. Tom also posts regularly in the network. While scrolling through Yammer, Tom discovers an informative article on the topic of collaborative work. He quickly tags Claudia and Mark in the comments. Maybe they will find the article interesting too. Tom had a long day at work. As he relaxes on the couch in the evening, he reflects on what happened during the day. Office 365 is pretty neat, he thinks. It helped me to organize and coordinate the communication with Claudia and Mark much more effectively. So did Tom's story make you want to learn more about how O365 can support you and your team? Then take a look at the next video to see how your daily work can be made easier and more efficient in the future with O365. Stay curious.